The human skeletal system consists of different types of bones. In fact, the adult human skeletal system consists typically of 206 different bones. And all these different types of bones can be categorized into 5 groups. And that means the human skeletal system only contains 5 different types of bones. So let's discuss what these 5 different groups are, what these 5 different types of bones are. Let's discuss their function, and then let's take a look at the following diagram, and let's place some of these bones into their correct group. So let's begin with the long bone. The long bone is called the long bone because they're much longer than they are wide. And the long bone consists of 3 different sections. We have our epiphysis, the metaphysis, and we have our diaphysis. Now, the epiphysis contains our spongy bone, also known as the cancellous bone. And this contains our red bone marrow that synthesizes red blood cells. Now, the metaphysis consists of an important section known as our epiphyseal plate. And this epiphyseal plate is responsible for lengthening and elongating the long bone as the organism, as the human actually grows. Now, our diaphysis is the long shaft, the long curved shaft that contains our compact bone that basically is responsible for giving our bone its strongness. So basically, our long bones are capable of resisting very high tensile and compressive forces. And that's exactly why these bones are responsible for supporting our body. In fact, the long bones support the majority of the body's weight. So we have many different types of long bones in our body. So let's take a look at the following diagram. So we have the clavicle, also known as the collarbone. So this bone here and this bone here. This is our example of a long bone. Now in the arm, we have the humerus, the bone here, and we have the 2 bones here, our radius and the ulna. These are examples of long bones. Now, if we examine our legs, the legs also contain long bones. So we have the femur, which is the bone that is much stronger than concrete. We also have the tibia and our fibula, and these are also examples of long bones. Now, if we examine our fingers, the fingers, specifically the metacarpals, are also examples of long bones, but these are much smaller than these long bones. So basically, long bones can actually be very long or they can be very small. So basically, what the definition of a long bone is, they're much longer than they are wider. Now, let's take a look at the second type of bone known as our short bone. So by definition, a short bone has the shape of a cube, and that basically means they are as long as they are wide. Now, they basically function by providing support as well as stability to other bones, and these short bones do not actually move themselves. Now, what are some examples of short bones? Well, if we examine our wrist, the wrist contains bones known as the carpals, and these are examples of short bones. Now, if we examine the ankles of our body, these contain the tarsals, which are also examples of short bones. Now, let's move on to our flat bones. So flat bones are those bones that are relatively thin and which contain a relatively high surface area. Now, these bones can serve 2 important functions. They can either protect our internal organs and our tissues, and they can also serve as attachment points for muscles because of their high surface area. So they contain compact bone on the surface, and in the middle, at the center, they contain spongy bone. So what are some examples of flat bones? So the skull, the cranium, is an example of flat bone. So we have many of these flat bones that essentially fuse together as the organism becomes an adult, as the organism grows. And the skull, these flat bones, basically serve the purpose of protecting our brain, our internal organ. Now, other examples of flat bones is the rib cage as well as our sternum. And this acts not only as attachment points for muscles, but they also basically act to protect the heart, the lungs, as well as the vascular tissue found in this region here. Now, other examples of flat bones is our scapula. So this is the shoulder blade bone, this bone and this bone here, as well as the pelvis, which is the bone of the hip. These are examples of flat bone. They have a relatively large surface area and they are relatively flat, relatively thin. Now, let's move on to our irregular bones. So basically, these are the bones that have a certain unique shape that we cannot actually label as long bones, short bones, or flat bones. So these bones have unique shapes that help them carry out certain types of unique functions. So typically, our irregular bones consist of both compact as well as spongy bones. So they have spongy bone at the center and compact bone usually on the surface, and they function in protection as well as in support. So one example of our irregular bone is our maxilla or our maxilla, as well as the mandible. So these two bones have an irregular shape. The maxilla is the upper jaw bone, the mandible is our lower jaw bone, and these function to basically allow us to eat and ingest our food that we need to actually survive. Now, another example of an irregular bone is basically our sacrum. So this is this bone here. A third example are the vertebrae. So we have the cervical and the lumbar vertebrae, and these are basically responsible in protecting our spinal cord. So these vertebrae basically surround and protect our spinal cord. So the irregular bones are bones that have unique shapes that do not fit these categories, and these shapes help them serve their specific purpose. So they have compact bone and spongy bone and function protection and support. Some examples include our sacrum, the mandible, the maxilla, and our vertebrae. Now, the final type of bone we're going to examine is a sesamoid bone. So all humans typically contain one sesamoid bone, and that's basically our patella. Now, the patella, or by definition our sesamoid bone, is a bone that is in the shape of a sesame seed. And these sesamoid bones, or sesamoid bone, basically grows on our tendon. So basically the patella is found on the tendon found in this region. Now, as the organism grows, as the person grows, we can basically grow other types of bones that are sesamoid bones. And these bones develop usually as a result of some type of consistent physical stress or physical friction.